Are you wondering why my workspace started looking like this? From this, your Slack workspace may be looking quite different from what you are used to see. In August 2023, Slack introduced a major design update. Yes, you are experiencing Slack new UI. Hello everyone and welcome back. I am Gaurav Yadav, a passionate Salesforce architect and multi-cloud specialist. On my YouTube channel, I share valuable insights and tutorials on Salesforce and related cloud technologies. Each video is carefully crafted to provide a good understanding of Salesforce and its features. If you are ready to learn about Salesforce and its offering, you are at the right place. Without a further ado, let's get started. This video is all about the new experience of Slack UI and its associated changes. I will try to do a side-by-side comparison of old UI and a new UI. For the old UI, I am using references from my older videos. You have to note that the new design is rolling out gradually. If you haven't seen it yet into your workspace, maybe wait for a few more days. It will be available to you anytime soon. Okay, now let's jump into the workspace. On the right-hand side, you are seeing an older UI, and on the left hand side you are seeing a new UI. Let's do a side by side comparison. In the previous UI, if you have seen, that was the three column layout. How's the three column layout? First column is all about your workspaces. I'm not having that screenshot that is having all the list of workspaces, but you will imagine the first column looks like list of all the workspaces. Second column is directly jumping into your workspace that is having all the things related to your workspace, and the fourth column is that whatever you are opening in your workspace, whether you are opening a channel, direct messages, or whatever it is, that will come in this big bigger column over here. But comparatively now, it is having new UI. Left hand side is a four column layout, 1, 2, 3, 4. That four column is, first column is as usual, that is all about the workspaces. Second column is that is introduced recently. Previously, you are seeing all the things related to your workspace. Now it is different. And the third column is what you are opening, how you are navigating here. It will open over here. And the last column is about what you are seeing. So very first thing is the home. Home is a view for all the channels, direct messages and all the apps, which is similar to the previous one. If I compare side by side, previously it was having threads, later mentions and reactions, draft and send, canvases and all those things. And then it is having your custom sections where it is holding all the channels, and it was having then a separate section for the channels, direct messages and everything. Now if you compare to the home, that is the first place to go for your Slack, or that will reside everything related to your workspace. So if I come over here, you will see now the options are reduced. Now there is a thread, draft and send, and all the remaining options, the sections, custom sections, which is holding the channels, and the last one is the channels, direct messages, that remains as it is. Now the options thread, draft and send, only two options, and where our other options are, they do have added into the second column. There are the other options, and if you hover over any of the options, it will give a nice preview what is exactly there in those options as well. So let's explore. So as the name suggests, DMs are having all the direct messages that you are having from any of your colleagues, and you can do whether you want to see all the unread messages or all the messages, and you can do the sorting, and you can start a new conversation from here as well. Activities, this activities holds, previously it was in the mentions and reactions, it holds all the notification. It is a one place for all the notification, and I will recommend daily. It is going to be your most go-to place when you are going to this new Slack UI. It is having whether someone mentions you or someone replied to your thread, or maybe the thread you are participating, and if someone having any reactions, any notification from the apps that your workspace are having, and whether you are having any invitations to join any of the new Slack channel. So that's about the activities. Later is all the remind later features. Remind later features we have covered previously into one of the previous videos, but that is from the old UI. Concept remains same. Now this is the new UI. Concept will remain same, but this is the go-to place for the later. Here from the activities, let's say you are starting your day and you are finding, let's say I do want to reply to this message after doing my research, or I do want to reply to this message after that. So you can save it for the later, and you can come. So it will act as your to-do list, and you will come and check, and one by one you can mark it as a complete, or maybe you can directly archive it. So we have discussed about threads were there, later is moved here. This is the only place that you can do the later. Mentions and reactions moved into the activities. Draft and sent items is still that is in home page. Canvases, we will talk about it. Canvases, Slack Connect, files and more. Maybe you may have guessed it. So this, all these three, four options comes into the more. If I click more, now you have canvases and one more new feature, automations. Now Slack new UI, along with the Slack new UI, workflows become more powerful. It is having a lot of new options, so that's why they are doing it as automations and having a little bit banner of new. We will create a separate video about it. That's a separate topic of discussion, because it is having a lot of changes and workflow is more powerful now. Under your organizations, it is having list of all the channels, people and the files. Now previously files were easily accessible from a one click. If you want to see the files, now you have to come to this point. You have to come to the second column, more, and under more, your organization and the files. And the external connections, previously it was on the Slack Connect, now they are calling it as the external connections, if you are having any of the external connections. So that's the major update. Concept remains same, just they have moved things here, and they are consolidated as wherever it was making logical sense. And I think this activity is totally making sense. It's a one place for all the notifications, and it is visible on top, rather everything. And now if I come here, if I scroll down, and within the second column itself, you will see a create new button, and previously there was no such thing create new. And this create new is having a lot of options. You can create a new message, you can create a new hurdle, you can create a new canvas, create a new channel, you can invite someone. So that's again more powerful, and if you can click one by one each of these, then you can explore more about it. So that's a one place to do a lot of activities. That's a plus sign over here in the second column. And you may have noticed now profile is moved here. If I go to the previous UI, the profile was on top right hand side corner. That was the section for the profile over here. Now they have moved. If you see in the new UI, there is only a question mark for the help. There is no option for the profile. Now the profile option is moved over here. All the things related to the profile is here. It's about first, second and the third column. Now if I come to the top, since we talked about the profile previously, profile was on the top, and even if you do have noticed, there was a search bar, there was a recent activities, and now you do have and going back and going forward option. That is very useful, and that was missing in the Slack previously. When you are working in the multiple channels, let's say I go to random, I do something, then I jump to the well-being, and let's say I do want to take the reference from the older channel, just I can click back and it will go to the previous channel. And I do have played around this feature a lot. It is even switching between different workspaces as well, so that way it is very useful. That's the change that happened on the top. A lot to talk about the changes in the canvases. So let's say if I go to the canvas, it's happening over here in canvases. Now we do have a list of all the canvases together. What are the canvases shared with you means whether the canvases shared from the channels, or maybe someone shared their personal canvases, and what are the list of the canvases that are created by you. So that's one of the biggest change in the canvas. And if I click any of the canvas, this is a canvas created by me. And if you have noticed, previously those canvases were opening within the same window. Now it is opening into the totally new window. That is very useful. Every time you click, it will open up into a new window. Now you see it has opened a three window for me, for two canvases and one my original workspace. And even within this canvas, this is very useful. Let's say I do want to jump to this conversation view in Slack. I can click on it, it will jump to the conversation. And if I want to go back to my canvas, previously you have to completely navigate back to that canvas. Now I can just back to the history and it will navigate me back to that canvas. That is very useful. Second change that is coming up in the canvas is if you come to this more options, now you can make a copy of your canvas. Previously it was not there. Now you can make a copy of your canvases, which is very useful. Let's say you want to distribute your canvas, and let's say you want to use your previously created canvas as a template, then it is very useful. Make a copy and you can retain, or you can use it as a template. Let me jump to the canvases created from the channel. Let's say these are the canvases created in the channel, my first channel. It is opening in the same window like previously, but if I come here and if I click open in a new window, that is that you can also open the canvas of the created in the channel in totally a new window. That is also very useful, I can say. And let's close it. And you still you cannot, there are some limitations to the canvases created into the channel. You cannot copy it just like the directly created. So that's the one thing. And if you do have noticed into the previous UI, that previous UI, this column is completely collapsible, but I cannot collapse this. It is still here. So that is one of the limitations that I do have identified. And yes, you can hide the first column. Just click over here, you can hide the first column, but you cannot completely hide this one. Previously you can hide this completely, and you have a full window of your channel or anything, whatever you were having. And one of the major questions that many audience and many people are asking, how I can switch back to the old new UI. So I can say there is no going back into the old UI. Once it is enabled for your workspace, you may have to remain within the new UI. There is no going back into the old UI. Let me know in the comments below if you want to know anything more about this new UI or anything related to the Slack. So that's it for today. Keep watching this channel, subscribe and share it. Thank you for watching.